My name is Dave Swanson, and I'm an ecologist with the National Park Service. I work for the Arctic Inventory and Monitoring Network, which is five parks in northwestern Alaska. In the Arctic Network, we have a set of weather stations, or climate monitoring stations, actually, that are some of which are, you know, 50 or 100 miles away from anywhere anybody lives. And so what we've done is we've put remote automated cameras at these sites that take pictures year-round so that we can see what's going on in the environment, even though there's nobody there. In the Arctic, there's snow on the ground for, you know, 8 months or so in the winter, even longer in some places. And it melts rather suddenly in the spring after that long period of time, so we call that the snow-off time. And then soon after that, all the vegetation quickly greens up, so we call that green up, and it has to happen quickly and in the Arctic because the summer is very short and the plants all grow for a few months, and then we have what we call senescence in the fall when the leaves turn again and then the snow comes back. You know, when climate change happens, or even just what we think of as normal climate fluctuations, the way that that's manifested in the environment is by changes in what we call phenology, which is the timing of these events. With the camera, you can actually quantify the greenness of the scene, and so you can be more sure that you're getting it right because you are actually making measurements as opposed to trying to kind of subjectively assess what the stage of the greenness is. Satellite imagery can also be used to track green up and coming and going of snow covers and that sort of thing. And it's very valuable because it gives you a wide view of the entire landscape. But then the phenology cameras, the close-up view, is good for understanding more about it. So you have specific information, you know the exact kind of plants that information is coming from. You have the weather data right from the same place. So it's kind of a detailed look at a small area versus a broad look at a large area. You know, the length of the growing season affects how much production there is. It affects what kinds of plants and animals can live there. So if there's a change in the growing season, it'll affect the productivity of that environment and what plants and animals can live there. And then it'll affect what migratory wildlife encounters when they come and go from that place. And they'll come at a different time of the year if these events come at different times. What happened in 2013, the fall of 2013, which was the first fall that we had our cameras out and that we had data for, there was a thaw at several of our stations in October and all the snow melted off. And for a couple of those, the snow came back by the end of October and they ended up with a relatively normal winter. But one of our stations at Serpentine Hot Springs, the snow was patchy all winter long, basically, until it finally the 1st of March, a continuous snow cover formed, and then it was a more normal winter than from March through April when it melted and the spring was a little early, but it was interesting that we caught on film what we think is probably a highly unusual event in our first year. We have four cameras out at the moment and we're hoping to put out a fifth one, so we'll have one in each of these national parks, and they're huge national parks, so it isn't really very many, but we think that's a good number for us to try to maintain because you have to fly there with a helicopter to get the data. And so it's not a easy thing to keep them all running, but that's what we're hoping to do, is have five of them eventually.